كتاب الله دستوري وخير الخلق أسوتنا.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يوم تجد كل نفس ما عملت من خير محضرا وما عملت من سوء تود لو أن بينها وبينه أمدا بعيدا ويحذركم الله نفسه والله رؤوف بالعباد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم. قرآن ويكلي. Today in the 30th ayah of Surah Ali Imran, I want to share with you just a brief translation of this long ayah and some reflections. يَوْمَ تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مُحْضَرًا. The day on which you will find, every person will find whatever they did of any good thing. مَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ, of any good thing they did. And then the word مِنْ خَيْرٍ here, the word مِنْ suggests actually this تَنَوُّر. In other words, the variety of good deeds are many. It's not one kind of good deed or a specific kind of good deed. Sometimes we're actually doing a good deed, we don't even know we're doing it. And Allah is recording all of it. You know, there are things that we do, we seek appreciation for, seek maybe even payment for, like at a job, or we seek recognition for, or, you know, seek at least some acknowledgement for, or we're conscious of the fact that we did certain things. But there are so many things we do in a day that are good, actually, not even bad, that are good, that are beyond our conscience. We don't even realize we're doing them. And they're being counted. You know, I met someone one time who said they took shahada because they saw a Muslim in the grocery store. They saw this person just walking, and the way they were walking, this person looked different, and the way they were walking, they weren't looking at any women or anything, they were just kind of minding their own business. Even though a lot of women were passing by this guy, he wasn't staring at them, and he's like, what is that? And he just started looking at this guy. This brother never knew that he was doing da'wah. Right, and somebody looked into Islam because of this guy walking down the grocery store. They never knew. So you're going to be doing something so mundane, and Allah will make that a good deed out of it. And you'll see it. It's not lost on Allah. Muhdaran. Muhdaran means it will be brought and put in front of you. In other words, the record is gone away, and Allah will take it, pull it out, and put it right in front of you. And you'll get to see by shock, really? That's a good deed? I did that? I get credit for that too. You're going to be in shock about the things that you did, subhanAllah. And then he says, وَمَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ سُوءٍ. And also every person is going to see, standing right in front of them, brought in front of them, dragged in front of them, whatever they did of any kind of evil. Any kind of evil. And just like there are so many evils we do that we're conscious of, there are so many others we do we're not even conscious of. They're going to be standing there too. And when a human being sees that, تَوَدُّ لَوْ أَنَّ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَهُ أَمَدًا بَعِيدًا. He will wish, each person will wish that between him and between these sins, there is a lifetime of a distance. Amadan ba'ida. Amad means era. Amad also in Arabic, they say ma amaduk, as if to say, well, when were you born? What's your birthday? You know, amad is a lifetime. So if there was a lifetime of a distance between me and these deeds, it's almost as though he's saying, I wish I had another life altogether to never have done this disgusting, you know, these disgusting things that I did with myself. How could I have done that? And you're brought, you know, those things have been brought in front of you. You know, the thing I've learned as an elder, actually, I was very close with in New York, told me one time that, you know, young people especially, sometimes they do bad things and they don't even realize the consequences of their deeds. Like somebody gets in the habit of stealing, or somebody gets in the habit of, you know, doing something, you know, filthy, watching something filthy on the internet or something. You know, they get used to one bad habit or another. But then one time they get caught. And when they get caught, they're just so embarrassed, not just because somebody else knows, but even at themselves, kind of, it becomes a moment of introspection for yourself, like, how could I have done this? You know? And it's not just about, sometimes you just need to get caught to be able to realize what it is that you're doing, you know, for even yourself, not just for somebody else. So in this ayah, this person hopes it was another life. How could I have done this altogether? I wish I was never even close to these sins. Then Allah says the most powerful thing. You know, in this ayah so far, it's like I'm being scared. First I was being encouraged about good deeds, but now I'm being scared about facing my own evil deeds on Judgment Day. And they're brought right in front of me. But then Allah says, that's not that bad. facing your good bad deeds is not that bad. وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ. This is the real, this is the killer in the ayah. Allah says Allah is in fact warning you of Himself. This means two things. Allah Himself is choosing to warn you. Do you realize who's warning you? It's Allah Himself, نَفْسَهُ. The other meaning of this is if you look at it as a maf'ul bihi, not a maf'ul mutlaq, what that means then is Allah is warning you of Himself. You being disappointed and embarrassed by seeing your deeds is one thing. But can you imagine when you have to answer before Allah Himself? I'm warning you, you'll have to stand in front of Allah. And I'll give you some I like to give silly examples to help you understand some of these deeper things. A silly example is you're afraid to look at your report card. It's an embarrassing thing. You got a bunch of C's, a couple of D's, two or three F's, you know. It's embarrassing to look at this thing. And it's also embarrassing that other people are looking at it. But what's really scary is after that, you got called to the principal's office. Oh, and your mom's standing there, and your dad's standing there. And you have to report yourself. This is the worst thing of all. It was bad enough to see it yourself. But there's a bigger problem ahead of you. You're going to be standing in front of Allah. وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ. And at that point, when I get so terrified of standing in front of Allah, Allah drops at the end of this ayah hope again. It's so beautiful. The ayah began with hope. At the middle of this ayah is actually filled with fear. And at the end of the ayah, again, there is hope. Allah says, وَاللَّهُ رَؤُوفٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. And Allah is compassionate, understanding, considerate when it comes to the slaves. SubhanAllah. Like when you walk into the office, when you walk into this trial, Allah is going to be compassionate, subhanAllah. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us qualified for His ra'fa, for His rahmah, for His compassion, for His love, and for His mercy. Barakallahu li wa lakum, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Amantu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi wal yawmil akhiri wal qadri khayrihi wa sharrihi min Allah البعث بعد الموت لا إله إلا الله آمنت بالله وملائكته